Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. What an awesome time in God's presence. And may I just say, may the Lord bless the choir this morning. May the Lord bless the choir this morning. May the Lord bless the choir this morning in the name of Jesus. Because they just kept preaching the message that the Lord gave me. From He made a way to count your blessings. Hallelujah. The Lord is good unto us. And forever He will be good to us. Hallelujah. I want to bless the name of the Lord for the privilege to stand before the people of God this morning. It's not a privilege that I take for granted. And I want to celebrate the man of God, the first man of this house, Pastor Philip. Whatever your Philip is away at the moment, but he can sense his love. I celebrate his grace, and it's under that grace that I stand before you this morning. And I pray that you will be blessed by his name in the mighty name of Jesus. I want you to just turn to your neighbor, to your left, to your right, and just say, good morning, God bless you. You are in the right place for a blessing today. If there isn't anyone to your left or to your side, turn back. There's somebody behind you or in front of you. Say something to someone. Then they say it back to you. And that is it's the blessings of multiplication. What you say to someone, they say back to you. And I pray that indeed we shall be blessed this morning in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Please turn your Bible with me to the book of Mark, chapter 10. Mark, chapter 10, from verse 46 to 52. Mark, chapter 10, from verse 46 to 52. If the media can help us, for those that have not come to church with their Bible or they don't have a Bible app either. It says, then they reached Jericho. And as Jesus and his disciples left town, a large crowd followed him. A blind beggar named Bartimaeus, son of Timaeus, was sitting beside the road. When Bartimaeus heard that Jesus of Nazareth was nearby, he began to shout, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me. Be quiet, many of the people yelled at him, for he only shouted louder, Son of David, have mercy on me. When Jesus heard him, he stopped and said, tell him to come here. So they called the blind man. Cheer up, they said. Come on, he's calling you. Bartimaeus threw aside his coat, jumped up, and came to Jesus. Verse 51 says, what do you want me to do for you? What do you want me to do for you? Jesus asked, my rabbi, the blind man said, I want to see. And Jesus said to him, go, for your faith has healed you. Instantly, the man could see, and he followed Jesus down the road. Hallelujah. Father, bless your word. Let it have meaning for each and every one of us, both me, the speaker, and those that are hearing me. Father, do that which you know can do, even through the pages of your word this morning, in the name of Jesus. Bless your being, holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah. I mean, this is a story we've all read, I don't know, so many times, a lot of people have preached about it, but I see a different backdrop to it. And what the Lord spoke to me is that your life is a series of breakthroughs. Hallelujah. Your life is a series of breakthroughs. How many of us have been living God for a breakthrough, even as we are speaking? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. See, the funny thing is, as soon as you get that breakthrough, you're believing God for another one, right? Praise the Lord. So, life is a series of breakthroughs. But I want to announce something to us, that you know what? The pattern from the day you were born, in fact, from the day you were conceived, up to now, is a series of breakthroughs. There are two doctors in the house, if I'm not mistaken. When a child is conceived, I don't know, if all the heat is on, he's very hot. Glory to Jesus. Even at conception, I think doctor will bear me witness here, by his profession, that when a man releases his sperm in intercourse, he releases millions, right? Millions of sperm. And all of them are vying. Everybody is fighting and they are whatever. Guess what? You broke through everybody else. Hallelujah. You broke through every other person to be the one that will come to be. Hallelujah. So your conception itself was a breakthrough. Beyond conception, your mother carried you through, all the ups and downs, swollen feet and all of that stuff. And at the end of the day, there has to be a breakthrough for you to come forth. See, no matter how much a woman goes into labor, until the water breaks. Hello? Until the water breaks. I remember for one of my children, I was in labor for a long time, but the water did not break. So they had to come and actually break the water. There has to be a breaking. And the funny thing is, with every breaking, there is always like a celebration on the other side. Hallelujah. I don't know what you are believing God for, but there shall be a breakthrough. I said there shall be a breakthrough. Because you know how I know? Because up to now, you have been breaking through. Hello? And there is actually a song that, I think it's Moses Bliss that said it, that sang it. And he said, you are too faithful to fail me. You will not bring me halfway and then leave me there. So he will not bring you this far. After all the breakthroughs that you have enjoyed up to this point, and then he abandons you. He will not. Our God is too consistent and is too faithful. He's too committed to your purpose for him to abandon you. Hallelujah. I come to encourage somebody this morning. Maybe you are challenged about your children. Maybe you are challenged about your career. But God is about to break forth and break through for you. Because he did it before, he will do it again. Let me show you some examples of people that went through in the Bible. Hallelujah. I think, you all know this. Abraham, I'm not going to get into all the scripture, but please take them down and go and study them. And see the pattern that God has always set. His pattern is for his children to break through in life. So your life is a series of breakthroughs. Genesis 18, 1 to 14 was almost the culmination of breakthroughs that have been coming before for Abraham. In Genesis 18, 1 to 14, he had an encounter with three angels that then finally gave him the assurance that Isaac is going to come. And you see, even in Sarah's foolishness, she laughed. In her laughter, to prophesy the name of her child. Hallelujah. So I don't know whether things are bleak right now, but you know the challenges that you are facing, all of those things, they are going to actually name that breakthrough for you. In the name of Jesus. Before then, he had a different breakthrough. Before then, in Genesis 17, 1 to 13, his name was changed. Hallelujah. Are you single now? You're about to be married. Somebody did not receive it. I said, if you are single now, you are about to be married. Because the Lord is going to break through for you. The Lord is going to change your status. He's going to change your status quo. Hallelujah. If you don't have a job now, you are about to be employed. Or if you are already in employment, you are about to be promoted. Can you see that your life is a series of breakthroughs? Where you are now is not where you are supposed to remain. You are supposed to move a bit further. You are supposed to move so much more further. And the ones that are in secondary school, they're about to break forth into a sixth form. Hallelujah. And not just ordinarily, they're going to break forth spectacularly. Hallelujah. brethren, you know, many, many things that you can go back and record about Abraham. One of the ones that actually struck me as I began to study this pattern was the fact that Abraham was the first man to give a tithe. Hallelujah. And then it's not surprising that there is this covenant that us, children of God, cannot get away from. The covenant with Abraham. Whenever we call about God, whenever we call the name of God, we say the God of Abraham. It always starts with Abraham. Everything, it all starts with Abraham. The God of Abraham. Before we then go to Isaac. Before we then go to Jacob. Hallelujah. And I pray that you will catch a revelation in this. And that's why I want to beg us. If there is anyone that does not believe or you don't understand what it means to tithe, it's such a covenant. It's such a covenant that people, when something is being spoken against so often, you better know that there is a blessing attached to it. And the enemy wants to make sure that you don't get that blessing, that you live in ignorance. Abraham was the first to tithe, the first man ever to tithe to Melchizedek. And that is in Genesis 12, 1 to 3. Hallelujah. Sorry, Genesis 14, 17 to 20. Hallelujah. This was after his victory, rescuing Lot. Moses. Oh, my God. Moses is another one that we can go to. Exodus 14, 1 to 28. He accomplished his mission by bringing the children of Israel out of bondage. Took them through the Red Sea. We were sitting here, the choir was singing. You made a way. The Lord made a way through the wilderness. He made a way through the Red Sea. They walked on dry ground. Hallelujah. I'm trying to paint a picture of the God that we serve, because some of us, we do forget along all the challenges that we have. We focus on the challenge and how big and how painful, or sometimes it's almost at the point of disgrace, that we forget the God that is actually over all. So I just want to remind us of these things that this God has always done. There is nothing new that is going to do for you, only if you stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Hallelujah. Moses took so many people through the Red Sea. That's a God. He opened the ocean for people to walk on dry ground. What is the problem that we have? What is that challenge that God cannot take over? Cannot solution for us? In Exodus 12, 1 to the end, the Passover that brought an end to 400 years of slavery, that was brought through Moses. Again, he broke through them. His first breaking through was when he had an encounter with God in the wilderness, where the burning bush, Exodus 3:1-15, that was when God called him. He was hiding somewhere. I don't know where you are at, but God is actually going to show up for you. You will have an encounter with him. The encounter that will propel you to that next breakthrough in the name of Jesus. His very first breakthrough on this side of earth for Moses was in Exodus 2:1-10. When his mother, they were killing all the children in the land, all the male Hebrew children. But his mother decided to keep him. His mother decided to stay because he had a greater destiny. Hallelujah. That was his first breakthrough. He was excluded from a series of murders that was going around at that time. That was another breakthrough. Because God preserved him. I don't know. Are they sacking people in your place of employment? God is going to preserve you. Because I know for a fact that things are happening. Things are happening at this point in time. Hallelujah. See, let me give you a testimony, a very short testimony. I'm an interim in the place that I work. I choose not to work for anybody because it serves my purpose. It gives me independence and flexibility. And they called me. My contract was supposed to end in March. And All of a sudden, I just got an email saying there's a doctor's sign, something that I need to send. I'm like, okay. I opened it, and they were extending my contract. I was like, nobody's even spoken to me about this. So how am I getting an, you know, an extension? And this was like in February. So I went into the manager and all that, and he was like, well, you know, there are still some things that we would like you to do for us, blah, blah, blah. I was like, well, how do you know that I don't even have another plan somewhere? And well, like, we wanted to tie you down. Because we know you are a person of integrity, and if you will sign that contract, that means you are going to stay. However, he turned around and said, but by the way, you know, the bonuses, blah, 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 this year is not as what it should be, and we know we are tied to you, so always give you an end of contract bonus. So the one that you've done will pay that one. But the next one, it may not be as sweet as all the other ones. So I just thought I would let you know. I was like, wow. So he said, what do you feel about that? I was like, listen, you people are actually laying people off as a permanent staff.
If you work in asset management, it's not doing very well at the moment. Hallelujah. But what am I saying? In the midst of retrenchment, I am not a permanent staff. They are not beholden to me. But my breakthrough is I am preserved. Hallelujah. My livelihood has not been taken away. That's my breakthrough, and it wasn't even anything I prayed for. And I am standing here really to give glory to the Almighty. But what am I saying to you? I don't know what the issue is. But believe in the God that is able to just cut you off without you even engaging anybody. Hallelujah. All you have to do is engage Him. Because He is committed to your purpose. He is committed to your destiny. He will break through for you. It doesn't matter how long it takes. He will break through for you. And I pray that that will be your testimony in Jesus' name. And we can say so many things about Joshua, but because of our time, I'm going to just keep all of that. The same thing with Peter. And the funny thing with all of these people is every breakthrough is exponential. Hallelujah. It's exponential. If you look at Moses, he took the people through, you know, the Lord opened the sea, he took them through dry ground and stuff like that. They got to a place where they didn't have water. What happened? He brought water out of the rock. Hallelujah. Can you see? There was a point where there was abundance of water that was so overwhelming it could drown them. There was another point where there was no water able to drink. Hallelujah. This is our God that we serve. He split the sea so we can walk through it. He brought rock out of the water, and He brought water out of the rock. Hallelujah. He lifts the one that is downcast and to be walking among princes. And I pray that that will be your testimony in the name of Jesus. Peter was his shadow was healing the sick. Everyone that they brought out, the Bible says in Acts 5:1-16, says that they were all healed. He commanded the crippled at the beautiful gate to walk. See, like I said, it's always exponential. He started with one, and then he became the master. Hallelujah. You know, his first breakthrough was an encounter with Jesus. When the Lord made him the fisher of men. Your breakthrough is always exponential. Brethren, I don't know where you are there, but God is about to take you to another level. He's about to take you to another level. You must believe. We were speaking about the mystery of faith in Sunday school this morning. You must believe that He's able to do more than you can think or imagine. Hallelujah. And the Lord is going to help us in Jesus' name. Somebody is sitting there and saying, but the scripture you read, what's that got to do with everything you're seeing? But you see, Bartimaeus had an encounter. If you see the pattern that I've been laying, every single one that had a breakthrough, the very first, I'm doing all of it in reverse, rather than building you up. The very first thing they did was always have an encounter with the Lord. Moses had to have an encounter with the burning bush before he started doing all of those things. Hallelujah. Joshua had an encounter by the laying on hands of Moses. And from then, he too, he walked through Jordan with the children of Israel. It's always exponential. Hallelujah. I tell somebody next to you, this is the least that you will ever be. Hallelujah. Because our God is exponential. So back to my mirror. He experienced multiple breakthroughs in the same day. And all he did was what? He cried for mercy. He had an encounter with the Lord Jesus. And the Lord said, what do you want me to do for you? The Lord is saying to somebody in this house this morning, what do you want me to do for you? Hallelujah. What do you want me to do for you? Because you are coming to his house, you are come to have an encounter. And so he's asking you this question the same way that he asked Bartimaeus. Because Bartimaeus experienced three breakthroughs in one day. Physical, his eyes were open. Hallelujah. He experienced material breakthrough because he used to be a beggar. All of a sudden, he can go out and walk and actually feed himself, fend for his family. Hallelujah. And finally, he had a third breakthrough, a spiritual breakthrough, because the Bible said after his deliverance, he started following Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I pray that when you enter into your breakthrough, because this is something, it's a warning that the Lord gave me. He said many a time we enter into a particular breakthrough and it marks the beginning of the end. It marks the beginning of our downward spiral, because we think we have now arrived. He's saying, I'm only just starting with you. Because I am God that does exceedingly abundantly above. I always do more than I did yesterday. It gets better with me. And he's saying to warn my people, don't get comfortable with whatever level you think you are actually aspiring to. So when you now land there, you forget where you're coming from. And the Lord will keep us in Jesus' name. Like I said, there is a foundational thread that runs through all of these examples. They all had an encounter with the Word of God. Find your Word and declare it. Declare with boldness. Declare it with boldness, with certainty that you believe this is going to happen. Hallelujah. Brethren, we are the reflection of Jesus. When Jesus speaks, things happen. When you will allow God to shape your thinking, things will begin to happen in your life. And I pray that we will go back and find our Word. Find your Word. Declare it. Walk in it. When we were speaking about faith this morning, we spoke about faith and work. It's two sides of the same coin. You can't do one without the other, because you will not achieve the results that you are looking for. You have to have faith, but you must also walk the walk of faith. Hallelujah. The Lord will help us in the name of Jesus. Reject anything that does not look like Jesus, because you are a reflection of him. You've got to reject anything that doesn't look like him. The other day, I began to feel, I think I came here and gave a testimony that, that some pain was traveling or whatever, and then it disappeared. And then, God actually told me that he had healed me, because I used to have problems with my knees. And God had told me that he had healed me in my knee. And then all of a sudden, I went to kneel down and I was feeling pain again. A couple of hours, I was like, this is not in Jesus. Jesus never felt any pain. I am not permitted to feel pain because I am a reflection of him. So I told myself what I am supposed to be, how I'm supposed to feel, because I am a child of God. I am not supposed to go through certain things because I am a reflection of Jesus. If Jesus does not suffer it, I cannot suffer it. Hallelujah. Am I speaking to someone? If somebody tells you, yes, there are some things that maybe we have allowed ourselves to wander into. I mean, thank God for doctors. Hallelujah. But please, we must do what the Bible says. You must speak life over yourself, no matter what it is, whatever the verdict is that you are being given. Look at Jesus. Was it in him? If it was not in him, it's not permitted to be in me. Hallelujah. Brethren, whatever you disallow is disallowed. But whatever you receive, you accept, and it will manifest, and it will keep growing. Hallelujah. I said your life is a series of breakthroughs, but only if you can get the revelation that I'm not supposed to be here, the same place that I am to be tomorrow. Hallelujah. And the Lord is going to help us in the name of Jesus. See, the one that is in you is the ocean divider.
The one that is inside of you is the rock of offense and the rock of defense. The one that is in you is a litter of people, is a litter of men. So he's supposed to lift you. And the funny thing is, of all the real estate in the world, he chose to live in you. Don't make him redundant. Did I say, did you hear what I said? Of all the real estate in the world, he chose to live in you. Don't make him redundant. Help, declare what you want, declare what you are saying, and walk in it, and you will see the manifestation of the Lord in the name of Jesus. He is our helper, our advocate. His name is Ebenezer. Brethren, he lives in you, he lives in you, and he wants to lead us. He wants to lead us to the next level. Your next breakthrough is just a word away. Your next breakthrough is just a word away. Tell your neighbor, my next breakthrough is just a word away. And if you say it and you believe it, so shall you do. You are not saying it because I said for you to say it. You actually believe it. If you believe it, repeat it again to your neighbor. My next breakthrough is just a word away. It's just a word away. It's just a word away. Hallelujah. You know why I know that? Because our God is the God of breakthrough. Hallelujah. He's the God of breakthrough. Everything he does is with one level of glory to another. And he does not change. He does not change. And I'm just going to sing this song over you. There is a scripture I want to read lastly. And I want to technically to please help us. It's Isaiah 46. It's a word that the Lord gave me personally at the beginning of this year. And it's a word that I'm walking in. It's actually given me a level of boldness that I never thought I had. Isaiah 46 from verse 3 to 4. Isaiah 46. It's very technical. I'm already in this. Let me just quickly go through it. Isaiah 46 from verse 3 to 4. He says, and I will give you treasure hidden in the darkness. No, sorry, I'm reading 45. 46, 3 to 4. It says, listen to me, descendants of Jacob, all you who remain in Israel, I have cared for you since you were born. Yes, I carried you before you were born. I will be your God throughout your lifetime until your hair is white with age. I made you and I will care for you. I will carry you along and save you. And I pray that will be our testimony. As you read that scripture and you actually let it enter into your spirit now, you will be able to actually sing this song. You are who you are yesterday, today and forevermore. What you say is what you do. You never fail, you never change. You are faithful till the end. Faithful God, I worship you. I worship you. You are too faithful to fail me. Oh, you are too faithful to disappoint me. Proving yourself in my life, I have come to realize you are too faithful to fail me. Sing it one more time, you are too faithful to fail me. You are too faithful to disappoint me. Yes, you've proven yourself in my life, and I come to realize you are too faithful to fail me. Oh, Father God, we thank you, we bless your name. This is our confession, oh God, because you did not fail the people of old. And you haven't failed us up till now, because you are the one that has kept us. Kept us from conception, kept us through birth, kept us from God Almighty through primary school, secondary school, university. We are working, we are parents, we are, and for those of us that are still children.
too faithful to fail us because you are committed to us. You will not abandon us. You will not leave us halfway. And so, Lord God Almighty, I pray, oh God, that you will water this word in the hearts of your children, including myself. That our lives indeed will manifest breakthroughs, oh God, of the God that you are, in the name of Jesus. That people will look around us and they will marvel as to your hand that is working in our life. And so shall it be, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah.